Hey everybody, it's 40 Warrior. Welcome back to X-Men Legends. We took care of the first real mission with the HARP facility. Beat up Toad and, all that good stuff. This part, I'm gonna finish up the little X-Mansion sequences here and, probably do the Sentinel flashback among other things. And now Toad should show up in this, so. And Pyro did too.
Hello, little girl. Come to talk to Toad, have you?
I don't know if I should.
Come now, dearie. Surely you're not frightened of poor old Toad.
No. I'm not afraid of you.
Oh, yes, you are.
No. My real name's Mortimer Toynbee. But they call me Toad because of how I look. Say, would you mind letting me out of here for a few ticks? Just to stretch my legs?
Yeah, right.
Not if you gave me $1 million.
What about a billion?
Oh, come on now. I promise to be good.
Oh, shut it. Why do you put a lot of abuse on the Brotherhood? Yeah.
You see, the Brotherhood took me in when no one else would. They're me family, and I'm sticking with them. No matter how many times the salts ditch me.
But you could leave the Brotherhood, and maybe even join the X-Men.
Me? An X-Man? That'll happen the day the devil needs a snow shovel. So, how's about opening this cell? It's mighty cramped in here.
There's no way I'm letting you out.
I wish I could tell you, love, but I don't know nothing. Cross me heart and hope to die.
That can be arranged.
You know, if you give me some information, I'd speak to Professor Xavier about letting you out of there for a little bit.
After saying you would never do it.
Oh, in that case, Mystique wanted you as part of some plan of hers. And when she couldn't snatch you away, she was plenty mad. Well, that's all I really know.
You are such a dumb fuck. Sucker.
I'm leaving.
Do talk to the professor. See if he could find it in his heart to let poor old Toad go free.
Yeah, that's not happening. Toad, you are such a dumb fuck. Now I see why the Brotherhood always messes with you. Anybody in here? No, but there is a health pack? Okay, why is there a health pack there, I wonder? Besides the obvious fact that it's a med bay, but no, seriously, what was a random pickup just doing there? Well, one thing I could say about Toad, at least, he gets the last laugh in the second game, which I really believe he is one of the best characters you can have. Because he has a lot of good attacks. So in essence, yeah, I think he's much higher up in the food chain in that game.
Alison, I didn't mean to spy on you, but surveillance camera showed you were talking with Toad.
I didn't mean to do anything wrong. Should I not talk to Toad?
I suppose it's okay. But you have to be very careful. Toad can be sneaky when the mood suits him.
Yeah, sure.
Yeah, he seems to think he can talk me into letting him out.
That's not very sneaky.
I said he was sneaky, not bright.
Alright.
Who was...
Her name is Raven Darkholm, but she currently calls herself Mystique. She's a very talented shapeshifter and can assume the form of anyone she sees. For all I know, right now, you could be Mystique in disguise. Don't worry. I'm pretty sure you're you.
Is she...
She's really more of a second in command. But for the past few years, yeah, she's been in control. Professor Xavier is convinced that Mystique and the Brotherhood are up to no good.
Again.
The problem is, all we can do is wait until the Brotherhood tips their hand.
But what use could I be to them?
We don't know. But you must have been a very important piece of the plan for Mystique to attempt to kidnap you in broad daylight.
Okay, well, I guess really there's only one other place I can go. So, let's do it.
How are you?
I'm not sure. Being able to generate lava kind of freaks me out.
That's understandable.
Hey, guess what? It's inevitable. She's just doing it now.
That's excellent news, Alison. You've made a very wise choice.
Thank you, sir. The Institute does seem to be the best place for me. At least for now.
Now that you're a student, I'd like very much to test your mutant abilities.
You know, for some weird reason, as soon as you said you've made a very wise choice, I was sort of thinking of what Tatsudoshi and that would probably say to it and how they would probably misconstrue it as some extremely dirty thing like they tend to do all the time. If you haven't subbed Tatsudoshi, do yourself a favor. The guy is effing hilarious. It's just like three or four of them just always chatting it up and making really, really crazy jokes. They're ridiculously funny.
Yes, if you don't mind.
But what if I fail?
There is no grade for this test. It's merely a means to measure the full extent of your powers. That way, we'll know better how to deal with your particular needs. Don't.
All right, so you get to do the danger room with Alison. So, my personal opinion of Alison? Actually, very, very good. She's actually a very, very good character, in my opinion. Once again, she's got the elemental factor to her. See? Which is effing awesome. Also, like, Iceman can do the tracks thing, which I never use, obviously. Magmamite, when in magma form, she's tougher. Which, well, you have to do this in order to get that. Fiery Blast is just basically, it's like ice shards and whatnot. Not that great. But she can build bridges and weld stuff, which is nice. Lava Fissure, though, I like, because it'll almost always hit and pop enemies up in the air, making it really, really useful. So yeah, as you see, definitely more focus-based, but I'm going to change that really quick. I'm not worried about the striking once again, because I have that burning form, and that's probably because I leveled up so suddenly. I should have thought about that before I did this. Herp-a-derp. And we get to deal with these guys now. Danger Room Robots. How fun. Hey. Don't like that. Do not want. You can die now. And you see, Allison's already doing quite a bit of damage. 22 robots. Can I do it? I should be able to. I did it last time. These guys aren't that powerful, but Alison's pretty damn powerful, so that attack's kind of slow, though. That's the only drawback to that lava fissure attack, but personally, I like it. Nice music. Catchy. And just as I say something about it, it disappears. So, it's early December now, and kind of, I'm about to start final exams next week, actually. You'll probably be seeing this next week, so yeah, I'll be starting final exams, which is always fun. In whatever way, that stuff can be fun. You know what I mean?
I win.
Oh yeah, one thing I didn't mention about Alison, she has an awful, awful phrases when she wins. Awful victory taunts. Terrible, in my opinion. Oh, Jesus! Ambush! Ambush of hell! Ambush of hell! Lies in the seat! I bet you can't tell what I was watching recently with the whole lies in the seat thing.
I win!
Oh, nice. Look at that combo! That's a 6-hit combo! Finally finding a time to use it! Because remember, as the saying goes, there's a time and place for everything. Such as ass-kicking. Indeed. So now I've gone through him 6 enemies and 1 point to 1.
Come on, get back up. I dare.
Get back up, he was already standing up, you dumb fuck! Ugh, jeez. So yeah, I got finals to worry about. That's, you know, that always sucks. But I'm not too worried. I have a bunch of papers though. That's kind of the thing that pisses me off. Because nobody likes papers. Unless you're an English major. And even then, I wonder. I hate papers so much. I have like 3 papers to do, and I'm in a freaking accounting, a business school. I mean, we're not supposed to be known for our articulation, if you know what I mean. They got all 3 of them. And a level up, awesome. What type of laugh is that? She's got such a raspy voice. Oh my god. Yeah, in order to get full effect on your attack, you have to pretty much go right in their grill and unleash it. See? Like that. And even then, it kind of doesn't always work out that way. Oh, Jesus! Sniper! Sniper! Sniping! I'm sniping today! I'm sniping! I'm a sniper! I like to do it in the junior and the spring. I like to snipe it. I like to snipe it in something I don't know the rest of the song at all. Oh god! That guy hits. Goodbye. How'd she become such a kung fu fighter? That's why I always wondered that with these X-Men. Do they just come kung fu fighters overnight? Because look at that. They do a crap ton of damage, don't they? And down! That part never really made sense to me. Because I doubt everybody knows how to do Chuck Norris-style spin kicks and shit as soon as they
We're
get in.
We're getting some interesting readings on your powers. I'll show you after the test.
But you see, I'm doing a ton of melee damage with Alison. It's not done yet, though. Just a little bit to take care of. Nothing major.
While this is only an exercise, you are in a minimal amount of jeopardy.
Does that mean they're daily doubles? You can kill me now, guys. You can kill me now. Oh yeah, I didn't mention this, but I actually got an Elpier's World fit up recently. And one of the guys there just said it to me very bluntly, and I was laughing. Your jokes are bad. Me? I die laughing at that. I was like, oh my god. That's kind of the point. You know that. You guys know that. As much as I do. I know my jokes suck massive donkey dick. Just like these guys suck at actually hurting things. I mean, seriously, this isn't really a contest to me. I stand corrected, I'm getting hit a little bit. But I digress, I can beat these guys pretty easy. Even though this is more turning into a punch-a-thon than anything, I mean, I'm just, you know, doing my thing.
Help now!
After your face, a boom! Actually, not that bad. I mean, seriously. It's not every day you get to beat shit out of a ton of robots. I'd love to do this at some point. Die.
He was a tough.
The only downside is she shares the same health packs as you do, so if you, say, have a bad day or something and end up with one, well, the X-Men, the next mission, will end up with one, which is kind of stupid. You think X-Men would actually have his own, you know, Xavier? You think it would have a bunch of them lying around instead of the one random one I found in the med bay? Hey.
Come on, get back up. I dare you.
Another level up! Awesome!
Yeah!
Aw, yeah!
The kid's got potential.
Actually, I was just beating the shit out of things. I wasn't using fire at all. Oh, shit.
Hurt. Professor, the safety protocols are failing.
I'm getting her out of there!
Wait!
Oh shit! She just went supernova.
What just happened?
Am I in trouble?
Not at all, my child. Scott?
Professor, I haven't seen energy readings like this since...
Uh-oh. We got another one. We got another Phoenix on our hands. This ain't good. Oh, I see, though. This is actually kind of powerful.
Are you all right, Alison?
I'm fine, Professor Xavier. And I'm really sorry about destroying the danger room. I don't know what happened. I just sort of lost control.
Not to worry. This type of thing happens all the time. Besides, I think it gives Beast an excuse to make modifications to the equipment.
Well, I've had enough. I'm never setting foot in the danger room again.
I understand this was a very trying experience, but at some point you must try again. It's the only way you'll learn to master your powers.
But I won't need to learn about my powers if I never use them again.
That wouldn't be a wise course of action. I encourage you to take some time off and rest. When you feel better, come back to the danger room and try again.
I don't know, Professor Xavier. Let me think about it.
All right. So, yep. Still gotta do the Sentinel thing, like meet in the war, or I can do up the Juggernaut flashback. Holy shit. I guess I'm gonna do that one, actually. First things first, I'm gonna just level up in Allison, just because I can at the moment. What I'm going to do first is I'm going to save, though. And then I'll get started on the Sentinel thing. Next time. These danger room experiences, they can take a while, I learned. And they're not always easy. It's not like, you know, those 101s or whatever where you could just hit box, throw box, punch enemy once. Do basic three-hit combo. Not like that. Naturally, this time it's a little more legit, you know. A little more legitimately difficult. See you guys then. 40 Warriors signing off.